Alright, welcome back. Now we're going to finish up on Chapter 5. We talked originally about the price elasticity of demand. What we're going to talk about now is a little bit more generic. Price elasticity of demand is very point specific. In other words, we're always going to be looking at one price versus another price, compare them, what's happening between those two prices. If we raise the price, is quantity going to change a lot or not so much? That's determined by that elasticity, inelasticity, or unitary. But there's a more generic term of just elasticity that's also used for describing the demand for a particular product. Again, these are the sorts of things that we're using to set up later on, so bear with me as I try and explain them. All right, so elasticity, there are factors of elasticity. What makes a particular good more likely to be elastic or inelastic? Right? The biggest factor is substitutes. If a particular good has lots of substitutes, then it's going to be elastic. All right? So let's look at that, right? More substitutes equals more elastic. Why? Think about it, right? If there's lots of substitutes, when you raise the price, there's lots of other choices for you to choose from. So when you raise the price, people are going to start choosing the substitutes instead, and your quantity is going to decrease further. Right? Exactly like that price elasticity stuff, except now it's a more generic sense. Instead of looking at two specific prices, now we're trying to consider, is a product elastic or inelastic overall? The definitions of elastic and inelastic are the same. It's just now we need to compare whether or not they're going to be elastic or inelastic, or what drives elasticity in your market. One of the other factors is the time you've got to change to a particular price change. So imagine, if you will, we look at one of the classic examples of gasoline, right? When gas prices initially go up, do we buy less gas? Not really. We can't, can we? I mean, we still got to drive to work, we still got to drive to the store, we still got to take the kids to school, we still got to take them to soccer practice, whatever. We don't have a whole lot of time to adjust. We just have to pay for it and deal with it. But what happens if the price of gas stays high for a long period of time, like say for 2 or 3 years like it has? What do you start to see? Carpools. You start to see gas efficiency cars. You start to see hybrid cars. People are adjusting to this time that gas prices have been high. So our elasticity starts to get higher the more time we have to change, because that gives us more time to find substitutes, right? So the more time we have, the more elastic we are. All right, one of the last ones is the necessity. All right, if a good is an absolute necessity, so like, you know, the diabetes drugs, right? If you have to have it or you're going to die, guess what, folks? That's not elastic, right? The more you need something, the more you have to have it, the more inelastic it is, because you're not going to be able to go out and find a substitute for those things because you need to have the specific one that you have. Now, if you allowed a lot of time for that particular, you know, drug to have to be needed, right? So if you need this diabetes drug, if you wait a long enough time, there may be 2 or 3 other different options out there. But when you first get diagnosed with diabetes back in the early days when it was first discovered that there was a drug to cure it, you had to buy the certain drug that was there. There was nothing you could do about it. It was inelastic. No matter how much they raised the price, you had to keep buying the same amount each month because you didn't want to die. All right? So these are the sorts of things that we look into when we're looking at a market to determine how elastic is the demand. How likely are we to lose profit when we raise the price because enough people go out and find substitutes and our quantity drops so far? That's what elasticity is about. When we get into the next few chapters where we actually start analyzing specific markets, we're going to come back and utilize this elasticity and sort of use it to explain things that are going on there. So again, bear with me to some degree, but this is elasticity and some of the factors that drive whether you're going to be elastic or inelastic.